Welcome to the Swan Show. This week is me in that episode. Welcome to the Swans Show. Welcome to the Swans Show. This week is me, Wilfried Bony.
Wilfried, thanks for joining us. 7 weeks on since you got injured.
Yeah.
How are you feeling? How are you getting on?
Yeah, it's better. It's better. So almost 6 weeks now from injury, from the operation. So I can say it's going very well. And then we take the things step by step.
How are you feeling mentally?
Very strong, very strong every day. So when I'm moving or when I'm here, I do the same things. Encouraging the players, motivate them, and then getting my treatment, everything, so making laugh for people, like always.
So you're still trying to play a part in the team's fortunes on the pitch, even though obviously Yes. You can't get out there yourself
moment. Of course, I'm in contact with the coach like every time, and then the players also. I've been talking with Jordan and Andrew almost 3 hours yesterday in the dressing room. So I think everything is going well. So.
What do you speak to Jordan and Andre about?
No, about the red card. I can say a bit, shout at him a bit. And then need to be like a leader now.
Yeah.
You count on him now because he's in a big form, good form. So you need to think about the opponent. You provoke him and you try to do everything to get him angry. So.
How do you see the position in the league table, Wilf? It's looking a bit better than it did couple of months ago.
Of course. That's what we wanted. The main part of our motivation is to stay in the Premier League. So, and I believe then the team will do that. The crowd are behind us, so nothing is impossible.
What about for you this season? You came back with such high hopes, didn't you, when you came back from Manchester City? It was obvious how keen you were to impress again. You've had a couple of little muscle injuries, didn't you, earlier in the season, and then, of course, this big injury. You must be frustrated with the way things have gone.
Of course, frustrated about the injury, but that's the rule of football. You cannot complain about the rules of football. Mm. The most important thing for me is to stay, to not give up, and then my head is always up. I train, I come to a treatment and do the same things like I used to do before. The treatment, the injury is coming. I didn't choose that. I think maybe too soon or maybe to pushing myself too much than to take step by step because I didn't play for almost 8 months after the African Cup. Mm. So it's been difficult without a really pre-season, without a friendly game. And it's not easy, but in training, like in training ground here or outside the training, I try to push myself up to get back to help the team and to do everything what we need for the team.
Mm.
And it was difficult, but after 4 or 5 games was almost going well, and then I got injury again. It's dropping also everything what I was planning. So, but the more important thing is to stay focused on what I'm doing now, encouraging the team, try to tell them it's very important to stay in the Premier League, and then doing my rehab properly, and then I take things step by step to come back in a good period and then try to work it again.
To get back to your best again, Wilf.
Yeah.
We did see signs of that, as you said. Yeah. When you got a few games under your belt, we could see you were looking like the Wilfried Bony that we saw last time you were at Swansea, scoring all those goals.
Yeah. I would say the first 5-7 games was quite difficult after starting to go very well. I think it was maybe before Bournemouth and after Bournemouth, where everything was going up. And then after, again, in Everton.
Mm. You got injured right at the start.
1 minute, 2 minutes, right at the start. And yes, I need to learn about it. I was feeling tight, but I pushed myself to help the team. I would like to help the team, but maybe I should be more clever than that and then say, if it's tight there, so I need to stop. But I don't need two mistakes. So it was push me out against West Ham, was the same things. I was feeling also tight about the legs, everything, but I was, the team need win, the team need performance, so I was always pushing myself to do that, and then it was going wrong for me. And but I get to learn that because I'm still in school, I can say, and the most important, then the leg is going well, and then I will work to get back my on my best.
And at Leicester, it turned out you ruptured your cruciate ligament. I mean, you carried on playing. It's possibly the worst injury a footballer can have. But you carried on for half an hour or whatever it was.
Yeah, it was a bit crazy. The first contact, I get a ball, one rebound against the players. So the full back, the right full back was coming to my left. So I tried to push in the ball in the top of the defender. Mm. And then I felt badly. I felt something like discomfort. But I think maybe it's just a pain, so I can carry on that. And then I was still feeling something when I was playing. But I say, it can be a pain, so it's not the first kick or not the first things I have. So I didn't think about that. I get the ball from Fabianski, hit the ball with the head. I fell again on that knee, so I was really painful. That time was really painful, so it was the second time. And I stay in the pitch almost 10 seconds, 15 seconds without moving. The doctor was almost coming. I said, no, it's okay. It's just painful. It's a bad step or something like this. So that was almost 76, 78 minutes. So it was still painful, but I still carry on playing, going back to defend, kicking the ball with that leg. Mm. I didn't think one time in my head then it would be cruciate ligament. So it was a bit crazy. So after the game, I was feeling really painful. And then they touched my leg and they said, it's better for us to do a scanner to see if it's not what we think. And then we done it. It was like ACL. So I was like really crazy. Like I didn't talk for like almost 1 minute when she told me about that. I was like, no, I can't believe that it's that, and then I play again, so it was like...
Shock.
Yeah, it was a shock. Mm. And I get home, say that to my family, say, what you can do? You need to find the best solution, try to the club, and then don't give up, and put your head up, and everything gonna be okay. It's just a bad time, you'll be through the bad time, so... Every time, so when you wanted to come back, you see a little bit, you try to come back and start to score and go, push the team up. But again, you get injury, so it's not the first time. Mm. So we hope then this injury is going to be the last time. Mm. But just keep your head up and then you will be back. You'll be back, you will walk, you will score again. So it's something you got on you, so nothing will change, it's only in your head.
Next season is the target now, Wilf? When? Autumn, is it? Or
Yes, next season. So what the doctor say, everything is fine, so I can be back in pre-season.
Really?
I can be back in pre-season. So you see, step by step, you see if it's possible. And so I need to follow his instruction and then to see.
And you mentioned, even though you're injured, you're doing your best to stay upbeat. And
Keep it.
I mean, anybody who follows you on social media, Wilf, they see you singing sometimes.
Yeah.
Maybe not so much dancing lately.
Yeah. I cannot move properly, but I didn't change. So the injury don't make me change. It's just I'm thinking about like what I was injured also before. So my hamstring, left or right, I was keeping doing the same thing. So that's a way for me to come back. You know, I'm not gonna stay in my side and then thinking about the injury every time. So I don't see what's going on there, but what I see is every day is getting better. And then the most thing I'm doing is to be happy, and I do it always. So
yeah.
I'm not going to change that because I have an injury now. Yeah, I'm sad about the way I'm not playing, I'm not training, but I'm not going to be sad like my entire life. So my family is everything is fine, and parents in life. So you need to leave.
And you like singing, Wilf? You're quite a good singer.
No. I'm not a good singer. But I try to joke at home with my boy. So
yeah.
I'm not gonna make a song here. Don't ask me to do that. Enemy.
But you've mentioned your family a lot. They're happy in Swansea.
Yes,
you've been happy coming back here. You obviously want to get back regularly playing and scoring goals for the club.
Of course, that's what I wanted. That's why I was. That's the main thing is my head when I was coming here. Try to get in your level. That's what I see. If you remember, I see some like in the interview, you say, I need to be ready. If I don't get injured till December, so that would be perfect. That would be perfect. But this crazy one was coming after West Ham, the Everton one, so it's a bit killing me. And then I say, I need to wait again. Because my body, my body used to play, train and play, not to stand like this. So it will take time to come back again, but it will be the same like before. Yeah, I will struggle again, but I will get there.
And you mentioned you speak a lot to Carlos Carvalhal. Yeah. You've been impressed with the work he's done, Wilf, so far?
Yeah. The most important thing is the motivation, you know. What we wanted to do is to stay in the Premier League. So we put everything we have with the crowd so to stay in the Premier League. So that is our main thing. So I can say, yeah, he done a lot of, he give the motivation to the players. He has to give them chance, he push them up. So I think it's going well at the moment, so we can't complain about that. Look at our position, so we're happy about that. But we want more to be secure, so to stay in the Premier League.
And ideally, the scenario for you, sometime early next season, back out on the pitch, in a Premier League game, in a Swansea shirt, scoring goals.
Of course, that's what I want. That's why we are here, so, and that's what I'm paid for. So I will do that, and I will back. I will first healing myself, and then try to work hard to come back, and then I'll do my job, so try to play and try to score and try to win a game.
We look forward to seeing you, Wilf.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. See you soon.
Fancy winning this shirt signed by Wilfried Bony? All you have to do is retweet the link to the Swans Show on our @Swans official Twitter page and we'll pick the winner at random. Good luck. The Swans return to Premier League action at Manchester United this weekend, having had a 2-week break since their FA Cup defeat by Spurs. Jordan Ayew remains suspended for the trip to Old Trafford, but big brother Andre and Andy King are back in the fold, having been ineligible for the Cup. King is one of 8 senior Swans who have been away on international duty. He played twice for Wales at the China Cup, with clubmate Connor Roberts landing his first cap in the final against Uruguay. Ollie McBurney also won his first international cap for Scotland, but Alfie Mawson is still waiting for his England bow despite being called up for the first time by Gareth Southgate. Having sat on the bench for his country, Mawson will be back in action this weekend as Carlos Carvalhal looks to get one over on fellow countryman Jose Mourinho.
Feeling is great because we got a break for the Premier League and everybody's excited to start again. In the back of your head, you always think please come back with no injuries. But I think sometimes a break is also good. Go out your comfort zone and come back with a clear head. So I think it's also good. Yeah, I don't know Mourinho that good, but Carvalho is a boss who always want to win, always want to fight, and he believes in the last minute, so he's very important for us. Let us believe in our quality and hard work, so it's the first start for us. Yeah, we have confidence, but Manchester is not a small club, and it's going to be difficult, but I believe if we work hard and we stay compact, everything can happen. I think for us, it's great to play in that stadium and such a big fans, and we have to believe in each other, and I believe we can do something. I think more hungry, we have to win, and Yeah, we know, like Carvalho always say, we play not only for ourselves, we play for our family, we play for our bread. So that mentally, we have to, yeah, have to go on each game, and yeah, we just yeah, fight for each other, and we know for what we're playing. So we are, yeah, I think hungry, you can call it. No, now the feeling is okay, and I think from Friday, Thursday, yeah, we analyze them, and then yeah, then we get the feeling. Yeah. But for now on, it's just working with trainer, and not everybody's is home yet, so we have to wait for the other internationals player, and then we start focus on Manchester. No, I'm looking forward, because normally I always play for the prizes, and now I play in the biggest competition in the world, and I want to see how this is.